God laid you down last night. He woke you up this morning. Amen. You ought to have a hallelujah praise. I said you ought to have a hallelujah praise. God said, look at you in the faults and saw my every need. Praise be to God. But you looking at me? I'm looking at you. You don't look like you're hungry. Don't look like you put your clothes on without bathing. Come on, somebody. You look clean. You look good. You look like God has spent some time with you. Amen. And I know we're going to spend some time with him. Amen. You hear me often say, I'm like the little child. And when I used to say my speech, I throw my hair up. I look all over the audience. And I find my mama's pleasant looking face. She'll give me a nod. Like, go ahead, baby. And when mama gave me that go ahead baby nod, shoot, I thought I was the best orator in the world. Guess what, I'm here at Shady Grove and I see all these pleasant faces. Come on, somebody. The faces are telling me, we got you, we praying with you, we praying for you. We gonna say amen. Amen. Just go ahead and give us the word. Amen. 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 God is good. Thank God for our visitor. Every fine words of encouragement and appreciation. Another thing I was taught, when somebody do something for you, tell them thank you. And then mean it when you say it. Isn't that right? Amen. Dealing with children will bring out whoever you are in you. They will bring it out of you. And I thank God. That's why Jesus said, except you come to me as a little child. Amen. I really don't have time to deal with you. That's what he's saying. Amen. Because if you come with your arrogance, I don't have time to deal with that. But I want you to come to me humble. Amen. I get excited about the Lord every day. But I get excited this time of the year. Amen. Called Christmas. I'm not going to argue with nobody about what day he was born or what month he was born. Amen. But the scripture do declare he was born. Isn't that right? Amen. And I'm glad that he was born, because he gave us an opportunity to be reborn. We honor the Lord in your presence. To the ministers of the gospel and our officers, amen. Our wives and our brothers and sisters in Christ. Amen. To our wife and her illness. But God is still good. Amen. It affects you because, amen, the Bible said you become one. Come on, somebody. I'm talking to somebody that really loves their spouse, amen. I'm talking to somebody that really, amen, really one according to the word, amen. That's who I'm talking to, amen. And if you're not there, then you need to get there. Because the Bible said that they become one. You'll have a witness there. One in everything, amen. One in going to church, one in raising the children, amen. One bank account. We gotta get some attention on that one. Amen. In the book of Matthew, in the gospel recorded, you come to church, you ought to have a good time. And you ought to be able to say, let your hair loose in church. Come on, somebody. Amen. The government trying to get in the church, but Amen. I'm going to do all I can in praying to keep them out of hell. Amen. Oh, they are not to dictate to me how I should preach and what I should preach about. Isn't that right? Amen. They're already making us be accountable for taxes. Amen. I don't want them to let me tell me or email me what to preach about. Come on, somebody. Amen. Gospel, recording by St. Matthew, just one verse. I want to talk about the name Jesus. Anybody know the name Jesus? Verse 121, chapter 1, brother. Verse 21 says, and she shall bring forth a son. God is going to use her to bring a son. Thou shalt call his name Jesus, which means Savior. If you're down, you want to be lifted up, just start saying the name Jesus. He shall save his people from their sin. Let me read it again. And she shall bring forth a son. Thou shalt call his name Jesus. For he shall save his people from their sin. Lord, bless your word today. That be further clarified. And God, these thy people today would be edified. And you be glorified. Use us now to your glory. In Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. I want to use for your message, solicit your prayers. As I said earlier, amen, that name, Jesus. That name, Jesus. If anybody know him, he can get you out of some tight spots. Anybody know him, he can inspire you. When you're not feeling your best. Anybody know him as the one that take care of the family? What a friend we have in Jesus. I remember years ago that when we as children didn't quite understand some things, particularly what's happening to us, sometimes because of who we are, where we come from, and hear mama saying, the Lord will make it all right. You'll have a witness here. She was talking about that name, Jesus. How many believe today that even sometimes when Satan trying to choke you in your sleep? I said he's trying to choke you sometime in your sleep. Anybody ever experienced that? But if I can just get my mind on Jesus, he had to turn me loose. The name Jesus will lift your spirit. The name Jesus will bring comfort where there is a problem. The name Jesus will bring healing where there is sickness. The name Jesus will take care of your children. You'll have a witness here. No matter where they may be located, the name Jesus. Come on, I need you to help me a little while here. Something about that name Jesus. Isn't that right? I believe today that names doesn't mean as much as they used to. Isn't that right? Some names, I'm not messing with nobody, but some names, I have to pull out the dictionary. Try to pronounce it. You know, we was named Clarence and Henry and John. Come on, somebody. Amen. But now, we have to get my 3 or 4 dictionaries. Put them all together out of the table. Whatever sound come out. I ain't missing nobody, amen. But sometimes I can't can't pronounce your child's name, don't hold it against me. I just can't pronounce it. Amen. But even back in the day when people would name their child biblical name, they felt, come on, a closeness. They felt an obligation to raise that child in the admonition of the Lord. It used to be a time that we would dedicate our children to the Lord. I don't perform that many, come on somebody, dedication no more, but we used to dedicate them to the Lord and lift them up to the Lord. I'm talking about Jesus today.
Yes, sir.
Something about that name. Isn't that right? Anybody ever go in there? You want your children, you want your family to be so blessed. You go in the room and pray over them while they sleep. You'll have a witness head and anoint them while they're in the room and not the room and not the house. When they're away from the room and not the car that they drive, and come on somebody, because we want Jesus to take care of us. Want to be blessed? Hook up with Jesus. I believe, I said, people don't care much about names as they used to.
All right. Well.
Amen. If you're going to talk about me, what I say it before we leave church. So you won't look at me funny when you come back. I'm not talking about your name. I'm just talking about I can't pronounce it. Amen. But not true when you're looking at the Bible. So the Hebrew nation, a name, was a very serious matter. To a Hebrew, ancient Hebrew time, that your name said something about who you are. Your name said something about what you stood for. You'll have witness there. Amen. Name was given biblical names. Amen. You heard the name Joshua. Joshua means salvation. You'll have witness there. And they said, name the son Jesus. Nobody gonna name their son. Ain't nobody gonna name right here. I never heard nobody name their child Jesus.
All right.
You might have in another language have you, how you ever say it, but I'm talking about Jesus.
All right, sir.
We're not Jesus. But you can name your child Jesus if you want to. Why? You name him every name. But we're not going to name them Jesus. It's because, I think, because we can't add up to the law. You'll have a witness here. And then nobody's going to name their child Jesus. It's because we feel a lot too much. Well, we don't want a name because what? There's only one name, Jesus. I'm trying to preach. But to the Hebrew, I say, hey, there ain't no name anymore than just a label.
Well.
In Hebrew, their mind and their culture.
Yeah.
Person name was, I said, very serious matter.
Uh-huh.
Because they believe names told you something about that person's personality and their character.
Uh-huh.
So when a name was told to a Hebrew, you not only told them who you were, but you also told them what you were. For them, the name meant nature, which describes you. Do I have a witness here? That name, I said, meant nature, which describes you. Listen to me, church. When a person's character changed, he or she often received a new name. Even in biblical times, when their nature changed and when God dealt with them, God gave them a new name. You'll have a witness here. You don't believe